Hi, I'm Dr. Ben Chapman, food safety specialist at NC State University. And today we're at a house where there was some severe flood damage. We're gonna go take a look at areas where food might be prepared and stored and take a look at some of the issues that might happen after a flood. As we look around in a house, you may have hundreds of dollars, thousands of dollars in things like plates, dishes, utensils. If we look at something like a glassware, this is something that I could clean and sanitize. I look at this and there's not a lot of, even though floodwaters hit this, I can either sanitize this at high heat or I could take a mixture of about a tablespoon worth of bleach and put it into a gallon of clean water and sanitize the outside of this. I move over to something like this. A piece of porcelain earthenware here that has a crack in it. So inside here, this is a little bit porous. So any of the floodwaters could actually enter into this, and it makes it extremely difficult to clean and sanitize this type of dish effectively. So this is something that I would suggest, it wouldn't be something that I would try to recover. Stainless steel pots and pans, similarly to what we saw with the glassware, is something that I can go ahead and clean and sanitize. Now, what I want to do, and I look at a piece of equipment like this, where there are some seams, it's possible that any of the contaminants get underneath and inside of this item. So what I want to do is take apart the handles as I clean and sanitize this. So it's not as simple sometimes as saying if it's metal then we can salvage it, or if it's glass or if it's porcelain. You really need to look at each individual item one-on-one to determine how well you can clean and sanitize it. For more information on this, contact your local NC State Extension office or go to the NC State Disaster Recovery website.